What up, y'all? It's Kinyo here, and today I'm going to be talking to you about a show that I watched called Lovecraft. Lovecraft new on HEB. HEB. New on HBO.
Chillin' with Kinyo. Chillin' with Kinyo.
Film is one of the most powerful tools in the universe, and that's why I wanted to take a second to talk to you guys about something that I'm doing. It's called the Times Library Film Festival. I would love for you. Times Library is a book of poetry that I did, and it's all about time and our relationship with these moments that we store and we charge up. And film has always been a huge inspiration to me, and that's why I'm creating this contest where it's a digital film festival, you know, contactless, $50 that I'll be giving out every week. And to submit, just go to www.kinyo.org and click Enter Times Library. Wow. Yes, so thanks for tuning in. Let's get into it. I didn't make any notes, so I'm just going to go off the shizzle with the wizzle, as they say. And I watched the first episode of it. And so it says it's from Jordan Peele, and it's my notifications. Jordan Peele and I don't remember. I believe it was a woman. I don't remember her name. But of course, you know, Jordan Peele caught my name because of his recent stuff with Get Out. So I checked it out. I'm a huge fan of sci-fi. The main character in Lovecraft is also a sci-fi aficionado. He's reading the book that they made the Disney movie based off of. The guy with the JC name, whatever it is. Not Jesus Christ. Which I thought. Yeah, but anyway, I didn't even watch that movie. But it's like where he goes to the alien place with the Martians. John Clark? John Cameron? John? I think I know it's John. I don't know what the last thing is. But anyway, so he's reading that book in the very beginning. I'll tell you what's really cool about this show it's just cool to see the blend of, you know, obviously those slavery times, but the way that they spin some of the slavery stuff, because slavery stuff gets old. It does. It definitely gets old. And not that we should stop talking about it, because we got to figure stuff out, you know, we got to talk, but it gets old. So how do you reinvent it? You know, sometimes writers don't know how to do that well. Regardless of the poignancy of the subject matter, but this is a really cool angle on it, because it's obviously entirely fictitious, other than, you know, drawing from real history. It's super fake, obviously, and fake how, you say? There's magic and crazy stuff. So they don't get into any of the sci-fi, really. Well, the beginning opens up with this crazy sci-fi sequence. But then they go into the thing. So basically the premise of it, and there's going to be spoilers in here because I'm just going to talk about the whole episode. Basically the whole premise of it is that I guess his dad ran away. And from what they're doing right now, I guess his dad has some sort of tie to magical powers or something like that. And so he's looking for his dad, and it's interesting, you know, so anyway, he's looking for his dad, and so he's trying to go. Basically, the map says that his dad is in this town that doesn't really exist. There aren't really good maps of it. I mean, something says that his dad's in this town, and so he's trying to track him down. He's trying to go to this place called Ardham, which was next to the city that's founded by witch hunters, which also really hate black people, because there's some story about some lady sleeping with a black demon, which also I didn't think that was necessary. Why? And then that was like that kind of stuff was weird to me, because I'm like, I feel like you shouldn't just throw demons into something unless you're talking about demons, you know. Like, I just didn't seem necessary. I was like, what's the justification, what's the play out? I don't get it. Sure, but it's only the first episode, whatever. But anyway, so they're trying to go to this place, and basically they're about to be killed by these should I tell you? Yeah, they're about to be killed by these white guys, right? Because it's a racist town. And so the white guys get eaten by a bunch of monsters. And one of them gets bit and he starts like transforming. So there's just like ambiguous, you know, magic stuff. And I guess the name of it, Lovecraft, is like witchcraft, but Lovecraft. So anyway, and then in the end, he gets to this, he actually makes it to this place. And, you know, from the trailers, you can kind of see what's going on. You know, it's going to be some sort of whatever. I don't know. But, yeah, so my view on it was, it was pretty cool. I like the sci-fi aspect of it. Only thing I'm not really into, and I wasn't even able to enjoy Sabrina for the same reason. I don't really like the type of witchcraft stuff. Like, it's just, you just give me bad vibes. It's like, why, I don't want it. Now, this is coming from someone like me. I don't even watch horror movies. Not because I find them scary, because I really don't find them scary. I find me sitting down to consume something like that really weird. I'm like, why would I? I'm gonna go sit down. Like, I don't even watch a lot of movies in general. I mean, I do actually. I watch a ton of movies, but in theaters, I don't watch that many movies. And for the movies that I do watch, like, it takes me a while to find a movie that I want to watch. And horror movies, they just don't contain, you know, anything for me usually. But I'll watch a few of them, you know, like, I'll sit through a Saw. I watched Human Centipede, I'll watch a few of them. But for me, it's not even about horror. It's really just about, you know, the things that I like about movies aren't in some of these things. And for me, I'm a very intellectual person. So, like, if you're going to do Lovecraft and you're going to get into some of these things, you can do it just on the sci-fi point. But I don't think that they're going all the way there. For me, this would be less sci-fi and more fantasy. You know, this is more like a fantasy series, and that's cool. I'm not really too much into that, you know, unless it's done amazingly well. Like something like The Lord of the Rings, where the attention to detail in the universe is a craft to itself. And you know, it makes it really fun to go through it and watch it. But in this one, I'm gonna be honest, they didn't justify me buying into their world that they were creating. I'm like, okay, yeah, I like what you're kind of going for. And it was kind of the same problem with This Is Us. You know, it's like, okay, Get Out was, you know, cult classic. You know, and I'm not even saying that he needs to live up to that, because it's like, what? Come on. Get Out wasn't even that. I mean, it was amazing, but not really. I think what was cooler about it is that it was so unexpected, which made it a cultural phenomena. You know what I mean? And so obviously that wasn't due to the creating. I mean, but when I say it wasn't that amazing, I mean, it wasn't like Jordan Peele did some sort of crafting artistically. I think more, you know, as gates open up for black people, you know, the first one through, like Obama, was he the best president of all time? I'm not even going to get into that because I haven't done the research, but he was definitely the first black president. And that's huger than his presidency, in my opinion. The same thing with Jordan Peele's first movie, you know, like the movie itself, him being able to do what he's doing in these genres is actually, you know, an achievement of itself. And it's not an achievement for him. It's a cultural achievement for America, kind of. And so all in all, to me, am I going to keep up with the series? Mostly not. You know, I don't really see anything in it that's going to make me feel like doing that, to be quite truthful. What else happened in the show, though, that I did like? You know, I do love seeing these different black actors. You know, I never really thought about it, truthfully, but I do think there's probably a lot of good black American actors who, you know, that I don't normally get to see. Also, I didn't know that lady was Jussie Smollett's sister. I don't know if that needs to be a big note, but I noted it. I noted that. I didn't even realize it until I heard the Breakfast Club talking about the show. And then I was like, oh, okay, Smollett. And then I was even more indignant at Jesse. I'm like, you're going to cause all this stuff? You're not even the famous sibling. You know what I mean? Like, my sister's more famous than me, and I don't cause too much of a ruckus. Maybe I do. I don't know. But, Jesse, you could have messed up your sister's career, you know? Emotionally, I'm sure you made a couple things hard for her, so. But, again, you know, you were young and dumb, and you didn't apologize, so I can't absolve you, but I couldn't absolve you anyway. I don't have the authority, but anyway, no, I just thought that was interesting. So, Lovecraft overall, I'm going to give you a 4 out of 10. I will not most likely be watching any of it. What I would love to see, actually, you know, what's fascinating as far as, like, there's a lot of black people in sci-fi. They're not as, like, yeah, there's not a lot of, not as much black culture in sci-fi as you should be. Usually, if there's a black person in sci-fi, you know, it's in the future. So, it's like, culturally, we don't know what's going on. Some shows do, but almost, like, every space show, like, a couple space shows, I believe, actually have, like, ships that are captained by black women, but there's black women, there's more black women than black men, but there's a lot of blackness going on in the new sci-fi stuff, and I'm really into space sci-fi. The Expanse is awesome, tore through it. The new Star Trek Picard, killer. I would almost wish I was old enough to go back, and I can't watch really old stuff, so I can't watch the old Star Trek Picard stuff, Star Trek stuff, I mean. But anyway, back to Lovecraft, 4 out of 10, main actor dude, is super buff, made me jealous. I'm like, all right, Kinyo, gotta get back to it, hit the bench, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Anyway, so that's my review of, this stuff that we got going on. It's very, I like the money that they spent on production. Yeah. Honestly, yeah, that's it. So that is that. Also, even the title Lovecraft is a little weird to me. You know, like, witchcraft is bad enough. What's Lovecraft? I don't want it. Bye. What's up, you guys? It's Kinyo. Thank you so much for watching the video. I want to end it with this little message. You guys know I'm working on a project called American, and it's a movie project, but it's more than that. And if you want to figure out more what it is, you want to watch the first movie, you guys know how to do it. Just come find me on www.kinyo.org. And click enter American, and there you'll find a lot of free paintings and access to what I call American, which also includes the ability to collaborate with me directly. Let's do it.